So statement of this theorem is, let G be a bipartite graph with a bipartition A comma B, where cardinality of A equal to n, and one more condition is given. If minimum degree of x, where x is in first set A, and maximum degree of y, where y is in second set B, if these two terms are considered, then minimum degree is greater than or equal to maximum degree. This condition is given, then we have to prove G contains n independent edges. So we assumed G is a bipartite graph with bipartition A comma B, and cardinality of A is equal to n, and the given condition is also taken, minimum degree of x, where x in capital A greater than or equal to maximum degree of y, where y is in capital B. So that condition is assumed. So our aim is to prove G contains n independent edges. So we know Hall's theorem. In that Hall's theorem, if G is a bipartite graph with bipartition A comma B, and cardinality of A is n, then G contains n independent edges if and only if cardinality of n of S greater than or equal to cardinality of S for all S contained in A. We know that Hall's theorem. So to prove here G contains n independent edges, it is enough to prove G satisfies that Hall's condition. So to prove Hall's condition, we need one subset of A. So we are taking, let S be subset of A. So our aim is to prove cardinality of n of S greater than or equal to cardinality of S, where this n of S denotes neighborhood of S. So previously we know this delta of G is minimum degree of V, where V is in vertex set of G, and capital delta of G is maximum degree of V, where V is in vertex set of G. Now we are using these two notation in this particular theorem. One is delta of capital X, that one denotes minimum degree of X, where X is in this capital A, and delta of Y, that is maximum degree of Y, where Y is in the set B. So we are using this notation. If these notations are carry over in this assumption, then this assumption becomes delta of capital X greater than or equal to delta of capital Y. So we are considering this as equation number 2. So now we have delta of X equal to minimum degree of X, where X is in capital A. That means degree of every vertex of capital A is greater than or equal to delta of X. Since S is contained in A, degree of every vertex of S is also greater than or equal to delta of X. That is, at least delta of X edges incident with every vertices of S. We know here number of vertices of S is nothing but cardinality of S. Therefore, S has at least cardinality of S into delta of X edges. Since N of S is neighborhood of S, N of S also has at least cardinality of S into delta X edges. That is, at least cardinality of S into delta X edges incident with vertices of N of S. We know this principle, namely Bayesian hole principle. That principle states that if M rupees are distributed among N persons, then at least one person is sure to get at least M by N rupees. So here also we have to distribute cardinality of S into delta X edges of S to these N of S set. So using this Bayesian hole principle, there is one vertex in this Y of N of S, namely Y, which is incident with at least cardinality of S into delta X divided by cardinality of N of S edges. So we have degree of y is greater than or equal to this one. Now comparing delta of y with degree of y, always delta y is maximum degree of the set of all vertices in B. So clearly delta of y is greater than or equal to degree of y, which is greater than or equal to cardinality of s delta of x divided by cardinality of n of s, which is greater than or equal to cardinality of s delta of y divided by cardinality of n of s. This is using equation number 2. So from this we can conclude delta of y is always greater than or equal to cardinality of s delta of y by cardinality of n of s. From this we can conclude cardinality of n of s greater than or equal to cardinality of s for all s contained in A. That means G satisfies Hall's condition. So by Hall's theorem, G contains n independent edges.